Okay, and here we have the best war movies since 1980. Okay, and the first one is Hurt Locker. Hawkeye from Avengers is defusing bombs in Iraq. Epic movie. And then it comes Das Boot. German submarines in World War II. Very old, very classic, very good movie. And then we have Black Hawk Down. Star actors killing some aliens. Very sad movie, very well made movie. Then we have classic Apocalypse Now, epic movie from Vietnam War. This movie has Godfather, Han Solo, and Morpheus. Then comes Talvisota. It's about Finnish troops against Soviet occupation forces. Old movie, but pretty impressive. Then we have We Were Soldiers. Mel Gibson kicking Vietnamese ass. This is like we are having fun here with the movie. There's no sadness or anything, just killing stuff. The Bridge on the River Kwai. British POWs in Japanese camp. They are building bridge for Japan. All right. The Thin Red Line. Nick Nolte rages at the Guadalcanal fight. Very sad movie, very good movie. I like it. And then comes Stalingrad. Soviet troops against German forces. Very miserable, very sad movie. I mean, the movie is good, just the place is miserable. Oh. Saving Private Ryan. Forrest Gump kicking German ass. Blood, guts, Normandy, everything. This movie is impressive. And then comes Act of Valor. Modern war movie about Navy SEALs. This movie has action and first-person shooter scenes, which are awesome. A Bridge Too Far. This movie has them all. James Bond, Alfred from Batman, Hannibal, Robert Redford, James Caan, Gene Hackman, etc., etc. Very classic. And then comes Downfall. It's not easy to be Hitler. See this movie. You know what I mean. Then comes Armadillo. It's very good documentary about Danish soldiers in Afghanistan. Brutal, touching, and most important, real stuff. Part 1 and Part 2. It's about Che Guevara in Cuban Revolution. Very historical movie. Must see. Then here is Beyond the Front Line. It's about Swedish volunteers in the Finland fronts at the World War II. Very good movie. Full Metal Jacket. Everyone knows this movie. At least everyone knows the army parts. The shooting stuff is okay, but it's really about the army parts. You know what I mean, you know. Cross of Iron. Classic movie about Germans against Soviets. Old but quality stuff. And the next comes The Front Line. It's about Korean War. Yes, there was Korean War. East versus North. Now you know. This movie tells you everything. Nefes, Vatan Sokul Shizilin something, I don't know. It's about Turkish forces at the hills of Iraq. Very impressive movie, very good firefight scenes. Must see movie. Letters from Iwo Jima. Dirty Harry making a movie about Japanese forces at the World War II. Very good movie in the eyes of Japan. And then we have Intimate Enemies. I can't pronounce the French name about this film. It's about Algerian War. Very historical, very good movie. I don't know where this movie came from. This is absolutely pure gold. And then we have Rest Repo. National Geographic's documentary film about US troops in Afghanistan. This documentary or movie, whatever. It's very good. It's very, very good. Very good, good, good. And then we have Platoon. The most classic movie about Vietnam War. If you haven't seen this, shame on you and go to see it. Very good stuff, very good stuff. And the last one we have The Ninth Company. It's about Russians in Afghanistan. You can see how much Russians get their ass kicked in Afghanistan. This is so good movie, must see. And here we got everything, yes.